He has been described as a champion of the Iron Range, a giant of northern Minnesota politics. State Senator David Tomassoni died today of complications from ALS. John Croman, who has covered Senator Tomassoni at the Capitol for years, joins us now. Hey, John.
Jana, you know, Dave Tomassoni's health had declined pretty rapidly since he announced his ALS diagnosis last year, and he'd lost the ability to speak and walk without help. But he finished his final term in the Senate, and he's being remembered today as someone who always looked out for the people he represented up on the Iron Range.
We saw him last week, went and hung with him, you know, in his room, and as we left, he just said, "I love you guys," and that was, you know, it's tough.
Senator John Hoffman of Champlin knew fellow Senator Dave Tomassoni as a friend and mentor.
Tomassoni said, "This is how you do it, right?" And showed me how to be an advocate for the community that I represent. And that's what he said to me. You may be a Democrat, but getting stuff done is about your communities. He said, "You deliver for your communities, regardless of your party." And then I would watch him work, and he knew how to work across aisles.
Earlier in life, Tomassoni played hockey in Italy and was proud of an old screen grab of him blocking Wayne Gretzky in the 1984 Olympics. In the legislature, he was known as a tireless advocate for Iron Range mining and workers in general.
The third floor of the Capitol, Tomassoni's back suite, where, you know, and there was always food. He always had some food up there. But one of the jokes was, you know, in order to get past this doorway, you had to know the password, right? And so the password was more money for the range. That was the that was the password.
He's sitting across the table from me going, "You okay?" And I go, "No."
He made the news in 2005 when he choked on a hamburger and was saved by fellow Senator Jim Metzen, who reenacted the maneuver for CARE.
Of course, they always ended off with, we're glad you're still with us, you know, so, which is kind of the bottom line, you know, good old Jimmy here.
When Tomassoni made friends, it was for keeps.
You know, when our family was going through some medical stuff, all of a sudden, lo and behold, this guy shows up at the hospital with a balloon, and it was David Tomassoni. Nobody else. I mean, it was like, that's a selfless individual, right?
He had a hard time getting the words, and he said, "I've got ALS." And I said, "Well, David, what's the prognosis?" And he said, "Tom, they told me there's nothing they can do."
Then came the ALS diagnosis, which took its toll on Tomassoni's body. He turned his pain into legislation, an ALS research bill signed by Governor Walz before a crowd of Tomassoni's colleagues.
This is about making the future better. We can all be proud of that. This is truly a good day.
He would say goodbye to the Senate in May with some solid advice for those who stay on.
There's something honorable about having a title like senator, though. Just don't take yourself too seriously. The axe can fall quickly if you don't treat the position with respect and humility.
Followed by a standing ovation from lawmakers who knew his voice would be missed.
He was a mentor, he was a friend. He cared about people, period, right? I mean, and he's a giant. I mean, I can keep going on in the accolades, but I want people to know and remember him as somebody who was real, he was authentic, and he was trustworthy. Say that in politics today. Real, authentic, and trustworthy, John. That's who David Tomassoni was, and that's what you got.
We also heard from Tomassoni's friend and fellow Iron Ranger, Tom Bach, who said, in his words, the legacy he leaves is enormous, and his passion for public service benefited countless lives. Jana.
John, you've covered the Capitol for decades, and you probably knew him as well. Fond memories there for you, I'm sure.
Right. Very easygoing, very quick with a laugh. And, you know, even when he couldn't talk anymore, he would still give you looks and you knew exactly what he was thinking.
Thank you so much, John.